Good morning, good morning. Another epic day in Portugal. It's been absolutely crazy. This is like the longest week of surf I've ever seen. Since the Nazaré challenge, it's been like back-to-back swells. Big swells too, you know? Usually like there's one swell and then it fades out, and been absolutely exhausted. Yesterday was the first time I took some rest in the last week. Just every day, 5 a.m. wake-up calls, barrels, big waves, turns. It's been non-stop. And today's no exception. It's offshore. It's like almost 10 foot. The idea is to get some barrels this morning and then rush back to the cave and surf all afternoon in the cave. I haven't surfed cave this year. I've been kind of pacing it so I don't get injured before the contest, but yeah, contest is over now, so we can push a little harder. Should be absolutely firing pretty big. Probably the best cave day in some time. So that's the plan. We gotta hurry up. We got the 6.4 ready. We got the vest as well, and the helmet. So we're just gonna get out there and get some barrels. Okay. Today, the choice of board we're gonna ride today is a 6.4 Ghost. 18 3/4, 2 9/16, 30 liters. This is the board I rode at Cochas the other day. Felt really nice. It didn't feel like a 6.4 actually. I felt like I was riding like a 6.0 or 6.2. So yeah, winning team, you never change. Let's go get some more barrels. It's gonna be a nice day.
Yoo-hoo!
Hey boys, mission number 2,
the caveman right here.
Yee-hoo. A lot of swell, a lot of offshore, and we're going to a very dangerous place. A place called the cave.
The cave, let's go.
Está incrível, vi umas bombas, mano.
Ora, bora, bora.
Já te mostro o meu telefone.
Vai, vai, vai.
Filmei, pois. Mas ainda tinha pedra de fora, estás a ver?
Este era violento.
Esta sim.
A rocha estava de fora, né?
Nesta estava.
Tu conheces esta rocha melhor do que ninguém.
Foda-se, nem aquela aí, pá, esquece. Temos de esperar mesmo a...
Quantas vezes é que já lá foste ao percebo? Quantas vezes é que já foste?
Ao percebo, 3. Ao mexilhão, 4.
Quantas vezes é que já partiste as costas aí?
As costas foi uma. Uma anca.
Agora vamos falar disso.
Thank you.
sai.
I made it over that chandelier. I was so deep right there in the foam ball and it just kept going. The cave is a really, really dangerous wave. You know, like you gotta be there at the right place, at the right time, because the rocks just stick out, you know? I mean, Antonio has broken his back. He broke his pelvis. He broke his back out there and he's still coming back for more. So you gotta wait, and it wasn't really looking that great, and then all of a sudden, dude, those two waves came for us, and it was just one of the best visions I've ever had, for sure. It was just crazy what went down. I couldn't believe it. And the euphoria of the moment, it's just, yeah, this is what surfing is all about, you know? It's just incredible what it does to you, you know? Like, I knew I had to go to cave today, and we made it happen. So stoked, incredible. Thank you, Antonio. Thank you, all guys. Everyone that was filming in the cliff, it was an incredible day. Thank you, Tudella, for swimming, getting the clip right on the reef right there.
Right there.
And yeah, addicted to cave, just like Antonio, missing his daughter's birthday party for a quick cave session. So hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Incredible session here at cave. Check out the merch we got on the website to support the series. Some really cool hats, t-shirts, jumpers. That's it, another episode of the life of the Mont Froth. See you in the next one.